election, deception, all the prophecies, the Q stuff, and it seems like it's died down, but I wanted just to, before we get into the other stuff, I wanted just to kind of get your take now that we're on the other side of the election and we've seen even some ministries shut down. What is your assessment of this entire thing now on the other side? We have multiple folks make prophecies Trump is going to get reelected. That didn't happen. You stood strong about that. I appreciated you. Your channel is an oasis to me. What do you make of it all now, a couple months later? You think it's died down, or you think it's still a lot of misconceptions and deceptions going on?
It has died down. We're not hearing about it all the time, but it's still there under the surface a lot. And the indication of that is you'll have some of these alleged prophetic voices posting something about a new vision and Trump's going to come back and the military is going to take over. And suddenly this post is getting thousands and thousands of likes and so on. So it's still there. And I'm really disappointed with the way many leaders handle things. On the one hand, there's been positive outcome. Many prophetic people said, hey, we never spoke this. Don't hold us responsible. This is, you know, a certain circle of people that became prominent. But some colleagues together wrote a prophetic standard statement that many hundreds have signed on to around the world, saying we affirm this. You know, leaders from various backgrounds, we affirm these standards. We want to hold to this. We believe there needs to be a cleaning up of the prophetic movement in the charismatic church. That's been positive. The negative has been some are guilty of what I call hit and run leadership. They got all these expectations, and it's going to happen, and you watch and the days and count. No, okay, this date, that day, and then when it didn't happen, they just kind of coast on. It's like, no, you can't do that. You created tremendous damage. You hurt many people. You brought reproach to the things of the Spirit and to the name of Jesus. You created all kinds of confusion. Now own up to it. Mm. Take responsibility for it. And if you say, hey, I don't understand why I was wrong. I mean, according to everything I know that the Lord led and spoke, you know, be honest, that's fine. But to dodge it or to say it really did happen spiritually, to go into further deception, that's been disappointing. So the good thing is it's only a small number that are totally in fantasy land, saying that Trump is the president, that Biden is not the president, that Trump's actually calling the shots, and you watch any day he's about to be replaced by the military and so on. So, you know, I've been shouting as loudly as I can for many months. It's not going to happen. Forget about it. 2024 elections, who knows what's happening then? We're talking about right now, this term. Now, so thankfully, it's a relatively small number that are going on with that, but they definitely have strong followings. I can tell you this, that if I made a post just saying, hey, let's move forward, etc., and let's learn from the mistakes and move forward, that would get a certain amount of affirmation on social media. But if I was one of these other guys saying I had another dream and you watch what's going to happen, that would get probably 10 times more affirmation. So it's still out there. And then others have done what I would call bait and switch, which is we're talking about, you know, praying for the elections, praying for the overturning of the elections, praying for awakening in America. And then when the election things didn't happen as scheduled, as prophesied, it's like, yeah, and we're contending for that awakening in America. It's like, hang on, you meant something different. You were talking more like the QAnon Great Awakening, you know, where all the pedophiles are going to be exposed and so on. And that's what you were talking about. Then it kind of shifted now to something more spiritual and generic. So I feel like a lot of stuff was just swept under the rug. But goods come out of it. And by the way, when you mentioned ministry shutting down, you know, Jeremiah Johnson is a young colleague and he's got a lot of integrity. And he had prophesied in January 2018 that if Trump didn't humble himself and if the church didn't stop looking to him in an idolatrous way, that he would not be reelected. Yeah. And then he got caught up in wrong political thing, misinterpreted a dream, and then said Trump would be reelected, repented, totally took it on the chin. When he shut down Jeremiah Johnson Ministries, it wasn't to say I'm so embarrassed about what happened, but to say, hey, there was a whole wrong thing we got involved with and the whole spirit of Facebook and the politicizing. I'm just shutting that down and going on with ministry God's called me to. So he's active in ministry, has a school being raised up and all that.
Yeah.
But he realized the whole thing that he became part of was such a miserable mixture with so much pollution and so much animosity and hatred that you couldn't fix it. You just had to let that die. And he had a million social media followers, just let the whole thing die. So to me, that speaks of integrity.
Okay.
But it was a real ugly mix. Last thing, I plan to write a book on the political seduction of the church.
Yeah.
And it's something that can very easily happen with sincere people that are concerned about the direction of the country. But when the number one thing, namely loving God, loving our neighbor, reaching the lost, making disciples, living godly lives ourselves, when the number one thing becomes number three or five or seven, and instead the number 10 thing, you know, political activity becomes number one, it's a recipe for disaster. And that's just what happened.
That's good. So thank you for clarifying that about his ministry specifically, because it sounds like he's still doing ministry. He just isn't doing it on a social media platform. So that's actually really good to know. I thought the way Chris Vallotton from Bethel handled it was well. I think he apologized, took the apology down and put it back up. And it seems like they've done a good job of responding to it. What was your, what did you make of the way he handled it? I mean, Bethel was a huge in this entire new charismatic movement, if you will.
So what happened with Chris is I found out directly from him that even though he has been speaking prophetically about who he felt would be elected, he's never done it publicly. Maybe he's journaled it or spoken it to an internal team. He was preaching a message and just let slip out in the message, oh, by the way, Trump's going to win. So he's mortified that he did that. He was the only reason he apologized immediately. He said, we want to model humility, and that's what we're going to do. So he did that wonderfully. No excuses. It was terribly grieved that he hurt people, terribly grieved that people were misled over it. You know, I was talking to him with some other leaders subsequently, and his heart was really pained over that. When he took the video down, when he got criticized for it, there were people saying, look, you still don't know, honestly, Chris. There's so much talk about election fraud and so many questions about what happened, and it seemed to shift at the last minute. Just isn't this a little premature? Because it's kind of like damning everybody else in the process. So in deference to others, he took it down. I don't think he was being double-minded, but that's the way you have to handle it. And look, when I had addressed it in advance, saying, okay, you're either right or wrong. There's no middle ground. You're saying Trump's going to serve 8 consecutive years. Either he is or he isn't. It's that simple.
Yeah.
And it's not like an ambiguous prophecy, and I saw a light coming out of a dark place with red and blue, and I think it means this. I mean, these are direct words. So I just said, please, no playing games with it. No manufacturing. Well, it really happened, but it didn't happen. And, you know, either yes or no. And you say, well, he really did win, but it was stolen. It's like, well, why didn't you prophesy that? I don't care who wins in the abstract. I just want to know in the end who's in the White House. That's the issue. So, but when I addressed it, I said, look, no one's going to throw you under the bus. Let's find out why so many were so wrong. Let's really humble ourselves. Let's step back from doing certain things and learn and then move forward together. Let's welcome the refiner's fire, the purifying, the divine discipline. And some did, but others didn't. And again, that's been the greater disappointment. I would have expected more like Jeremiah, more like Chris. And instead, that was the minority, sadly.
Thank you so much, Dr. Michael Brown. Guys, there you have it. Make sure you subscribe, like, all that kind of stuff. And send Dr. Michael Brown some love in his comments and on his Twitter. He responds to a lot of his tweets. So, Dr. Michael Brown, thank you so much. This was incredible. Probably my favorite stream yet. So, thank you so much.
Awesome. God bless you, man. Thank you.
God bless you. Joshua the King came down and bore it all. Yeah, conversations front of the fireplace. All of my mistakes, how do I erase? Wanna operate at a higher pace. Birth pains causing the body to dilate on a first name basis with the worst.